traffic contains PHs. Here we have a diesel-powered school bus, but there are also other things that create PHs and other things that create fine particle pollution. And here we are showing a cigarette, so tobacco smoke and secondhand tobacco smoke are a source of PHs and particulate matter. And then I've got a satellite photo of Southern California during one of the big wildfire episodes a few years back. And this photo is actually taken from a children's health study paper. The children's health study is a large study of 12 different communities in Southern California. And it was designed to look at the effect of air pollution on lung function growth. But they are following the kids longitudinally, and they were able to thus study the impact of wildland fire smoke on symptoms in both non-asthmatic and asthmatic children. And in fact, there was a major impact, major increase in asthma symptoms among the kids with asthma, but there were also increases in wheezing and cough in the kids without asthma during this heavy wildfire exposure episode. So tobacco smoke is known to be a major risk factor for asthma, and even in utero. So when the fetus is in the mother's uterus and the mother's smoking, it's been shown that there is an increased risk of asthma developing in the kid after the kid is born. And again, this comes from the children's health study, which I just talked about in terms of wildland fire smoke. They also showed that there was this effect of maternal smoking during pregnancy to increase the risk of asthma. But even after a child is born, if they're exposed to tobacco smoke, they will have greater problems. So this slide is showing data from the National Health and Nutrition Examination Survey, NHANES, in kids that were able to do lung function testing from ages 8 to 16. And they also measured directly exposure to tobacco smoke by measuring plasma cotinine, which is a biomarker of tobacco smoke exposure. It's a metabolite of nicotine. And here we're showing the percentage of individuals with lung function below 80% of predicted. And the kids with higher levels of cotinine in the red bar have a greater percentage of low lung function. And these are kids with asthma. So this slide is also from the Southern California Children's Health Study. They were able to look in their 4,000 plus kids at those that had developed asthma before the age of 5. And that was about 338 individual kids. And they had a very extensive questionnaire about environmental exposures. And I'm showing you some of the data here. If a child grew up in a house where there was wood or oil smoke exposure to soot from, let's say, a local power plant, or exposure to a lot of motor vehicle exhaust, there was 70% increased risk for early age onset asthma. If there was exposure to cockroaches, there was 100% increased risk, or twofold increase. But herbicides and pesticides, two chemicals, there were increased, even greater increased risk, 2.4 times increased risk with pesticides and 4.6 increased risk of herbicides. So the children exposed to herbicides were mostly those that lived near a farm.